So far, we've seen how you can use CSS to style your text, but we can also use CSS to completely change the layout of our page. That means we can move things around, change their size, even put them on top of each other. But what are the things we want to move around? Sometimes there are elements that we've already made, like a certain paragraph or a certain heading. But oftentimes, there are a group of elements that we've made, like a selection of text or a heading and a few paragraphs. In order to move them around together as a unit, we need to introduce two new HTML tags, which we call the grouping elements. We didn't talk about them before CSS because they're only useful when combined with CSS. They have no semantic meaning to the browser. The first tag is the span tag, and it's what we use for grouping a selection of text. Let's say we want to color this word love red, and we just want to color the word, not the rest of the heading. We'll put our cursor before love, type the start tag for span, put it after, type the end tag. Okay, now we want to style this span of characters. We could make a rule to color all spans on the page, but we may not want them all to be red. Let's give the span a class of Loveydovey and add a rule just for elements that have the class Loveydovey. So .loveydovey color red. Look how Loveydovey that text is now. So spans are good for grouping selections of text. How do we group a bunch of elements together? That's where the div tag comes in. Let's say we want to group this bottom section, the official info header and the paragraphs and picture below it. To do that, I'll put my cursor before the H3 and do the start tag for div, and then go down to the final paragraph and write the end tag for div. We have a div, now we need to style it. To style the div, I'm going to give it an ID, official info, and then add a rule for it up here. So hash official info and background, and let's make it a nice gray. Let's pick out that's good. So now you can see the div has become a gray box containing all of the elements inside of it. And it's different from if we'd given each of them a gray background separately. If we did that, there'd be a space in between them that wouldn't go gray. We have to make a div if we want a box around everything. You can think of span as being for grouping text, and you can think of a div for grouping elements. But there's another way to distinguish them as well. You see, there are two types of elements in the CSS world, inline and block. An inline element does not have a new line after it. Like if you make multiple of them, they'll all be on the same line. A few examples we've talked about are A and image. And you can see with this image how it just runs into the text next to it. There's no new line after it. A block element does have a new line after it, and that is what most HTML tags create. Look at all the examples on this page. The headings, the paragraphs, the lists. The browser put new lines after all of them without you needing to write a BR tag. What does that have to do with span and div? Well, a span creates an inline element, and a div creates a block element. That means that if you add a div and don't add any other style, the browser will blockify that part of the page. Like that bit of text I just wrapped in a div now has new lines before and after. And maybe that's what you want. Just keep this difference in mind and keep going, because there's a lot more we can do with these tags, especially the mighty div.